Tonight on Kitchen Nightmares, Chef Ramsay heads to Boston's Little Italy to help two brothers.
Anthony, don't take the wrong stuff. I'll kill you.
Who are at war with each other.
Anthony, you've ruined the business.
I hate his attitude. I hate working with him.
While one fights for respect.
He doesn't respect me, and I don't respect him because I think he laid down and died.
The other,
food sucks anyway,
is at the end of his rope.
You're going to get a complaint either way. They're going to wait too long, or they're going to send it back.
And the family is losing hope.
He feels so defeated.
I can see it.
Now Chef Ramsay faces one of his toughest challenges yet.
It's like a ticking time bomb that's about to explode.
Fixing an Italian restaurant in the most competitive part of the city.
You can't even be bothered to cook fresh food? Come on!
With an owner who has lost his will.
You want to do this?
I don't know.
Well, you have to make a decision today.
It's going to be a battle in Boston.
Come on.
No cooking. I'm not doing it.
Tonight on Kitchen Nightmares.
Why not go back in?
The city of Boston has many great attributes, but the treasure of the North End is its outstanding Italian food, served at over 150 Italian restaurants. The first fine dining establishment in this neighborhood was Davide, which opened in 1982.
Davide, back in the heyday, it was the number one Italian restaurant in Boston. It was incredible. There was always a line at the door.
What's the name?
If you didn't make reservations 3 weeks in advance, you could not get in.
In 1997, then maitre d' Frank and his brother Anthony fulfilled the dream by purchasing Davide at the height of its popularity.
This is amazing.
When we bought the restaurant, we were making money. I felt like we hit a gold mine.
Are they liking the chicken special?
They're liking it. I'm working with Frankie, and my life is wonderful.
The restaurant started off strong, but within the first couple years, Frank found out that Anthony was embezzling money.
I went into the account. Whenever I needed money, if I had access, I would take money to, you know, buy painkillers, whatever.
He was addicted to painkillers, heroin. He's been in detox, in jail, he's out of jail. The responsibility of keeping anything open was always my shoulders, basically. There was no one else there to help.
It's 3:30. You got to get ready for dinner.
It's different. You're going to get anyways tonight.
No, you're not. When Anthony left, Frank gave up. He's broken mentally and physically.
Oh, my God. I can't work like this.
And little by little, it's broken a restaurant.
Since I've been back, I am not the same person.
Hi. Good evening.
I'm in recovery. I'm doing well. Those days are behind me. I'm here. I'm responsible. And I'm making the restaurant a priority.
Right this way.
Let's forget about the past and move on. And I don't think he has. I don't think he can.
Shut the up. Take the food that's up in the window and come back. That's all I ask. Go away.
But at the same time, he should take some responsibility of giving up and not putting the whole blame on me because of what I did.
Anthony, don't take the wrong stuff. I'll kill you.
Right now, my relationship with Anthony is not at his best. This is it. You know? He has no more chances. It's all over.
Do hot water. Get the out. Don't waste my time.
Frankie will not listen to me.
Hey, moron, this is your tape.
Get the out of here, really. He's all, you know, just hurt and spiteful.
Oh, my God, Anthony. Anthony, why don't you go kill yourself?
I think that Frankie has a lot of pent-up anger and resentment towards Anthony. If it can't be put aside, I really can't see the restaurant succeeding. It's killing them.
We need help extremely badly because we've been living month to month.
Are we going to be able to take checks this week?
If we close the door tomorrow, we would be out $1 million.
Frankie and me always have the conflict. That's why Chef Ramsay, I think, is the answer to help us.
If things don't turn around, we will close the doors.
All right, the only way to understand Boston properly is jump on one of these trolleys, because those guys have really got their fingers on the pulse. Morning.
Welcome aboard.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
Teddy?
Ted.
Right, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you. Where are you heading?
North End, please.
One of my favorite places.
You ever heard of the restaurant Davide?
Well, it's funny you say that. It's on our tour route. We drive by it probably 4 times a day, and I don't know anybody that's really ever gone.
That's not good news.
It's not great news. With so many restaurants in Boston, and we recommend many of them, and I don't know a driver that really recommends Davide.
Unbelievable. Wish me luck.
Well, good luck at Davide. Nice to see you, Gordon.
Good to see you, buddy. Davide. Down below. Whoa. Hello.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
Very good. Nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
Anthony Giswaldi.
Anthony, Gordon Ramsay. Good to see you, buddy. You are the...
One of the owners.
Owners. One of them.
One of them. My brother, Frank. Okay, he's
brilliant.
In the kitchen.
What a quaint little place. And how long have you owned it?
1997.
What was the last thing you changed here?
We did the boots over and we took the wallpaper off. We haven't changed as much with the times, I believe. Time moved on and Frankie stayed right in 1997, and he won't change because he gave up. That's simple.
Let's get everybody together and have a proper staff meeting, yeah?
Sounds Please. Good.
Thanks, Anthony. Hello.
Hi, Maria.
Maria, that's my mother.
Oh, wow. Okay, you work here as well?
She keeps the peace. She's a negotiator.
And this is?
I'm Deborah.
Deborah, nice to see you.
Nice my
wife.
You.
Who's
your wife?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Frank.
Frank, good to see you, buddy. And Frank is your big brother?
Yes.
Fantastic.
Hi, I'm Kim. I'm Frank's wife.
Frank's wife. Brilliant. Take a seat, please. First of all, let's find out the truth. How long has it been slow?
At least a good 3 years.
And you're in the kitchen. You cook.
My job was in the dining room all my life. I ran the restaurant. In the kitchen, I learned, I picked up.
Well, how did you buy it?
My mother gave me the money, and me and my brother ended up buying it together.
Okay, so it's literally a 50-50 business.
Everything's supposed to be 50-50.
Right. What does that mean? Help me out.
Anthony has been in and out of the restaurant over the 13 years.
What happened?
You know, I'm hooked on painkillers. I took money, got in trouble, went to jail, the whole nine yards. I worked there 7 days a week by myself. Frankie got left with the whole It got to him. Got depressed, he got burnt out. Money went down every year.
Naturally.
I did damage to the business, but you cannot get over the past. If you can't put the past behind you, we can't go on.
When you've been burnt 6 times, it's hard to say, yeah, okay, that's in the past.
Anthony is trying to make amends. Everything he's done is being criticized. Every little thing is being nitpicked.
He's because of the past.
Because of the past.
You know, everything is Anthony, Anthony, and I think he doesn't take any blame for anything that's happened anywhere.
Is that right?
What do you mean, the blame? I was gone. The business, it was like abandoned. And nothing was done.
No, Anthony, you've ruined the business. You've destroyed it.
I never wanted to be in a restaurant by myself.
I mean, come on, I'm mad, I'm pissed. I'll tell you to go yourself for the you put me through.
Oh, my God, fine.
Anthony, never apologize, never. It's like, kid, don't you understand what you've done? You put me in the position I am now. But I like to beat him up.
Here's the problem, I think. He doesn't respect me for anything because the past, everything. And I don't respect him because I think he laid down and died.
Wow.
Coming up, Chef Ramsay digs in.
It's really spongy and horrible.
And uncovers a terrifying truth about Davide.
He is done. He's on the floor.
He feels so defeated.
I can see it.
Then, Frank not only loses control of the kitchen.
Now, this is the way it is. Don't come back with it.
But also his mind. Can Chef Ramsay get Frank back on track?
Why did you send it? We're screwed.
I'm not cooking. I'm not doing it.
Or is this owner and this restaurant impossible to save? Within minutes of his arrival, Chef Ramsay was confronted with the bad blood that exists between the two brothers.
Anthony, you've ruined the business.
And I don't respect him because I think he laid down and died.
And while his relationship with Anthony is at the breaking point, Frank wants to prove that his cooking skills have not suffered.
Thank you. And this is Andrew. Andrew. Thank you, Andrew. Recommendations?
There isn't a bad thing on the menu. Caesar salad's made right in the dining room from scratch.
Yep. Okay, good. Nice.
There is great potential here. We just need someone like Gordon Ramsay to come in because the relationship between Frank and Anthony is kind of sabotaging the restaurant. All the pasta's handmade.
That's a big positive. All the pasta's handmade.
Yeah, all handmade.
That's incredible. Let's start off with Il Volantini Melanzani.
The melanzani?
Yeah.
Sure.
Gotta go for the Caesar salad table side. Love that idea. And the fresh lobster ravioli.
All right.
The rack of lamb. I'll go for that as well. I want to see as much as I can and travel across Italy. Yeah? Brilliant.
Yep. I hope so. How's the food?
I think it can call. Trying to push it out when the attitude's there, when he wants to.
Uh-huh. How old's Frank?
47.
47. He looks older than that.
Stress.
Jeez.
What's he having? Let's start with the involtini.
Don't talk to me, just write it down.
All right.
I don't like talking to nobody. I'm nervous, but like at the same time, it's like, come on, bring the test on. I know I can pass. I'm not blowing my own smoke on my ass, but that food is good. Prepare the Caesar. Anybody got the Caesar going?
Brilliant. Tableside Caesar in the north end of Boston, right?
Yep.
Then you're going right to the very basics. You got an egg yolk there as well?
Egg yolk, garlic, anchovies.
Wow.
Who would ever thought I'd be making a Caesar for Gordon Ramsay? I love doing the Caesar salad, so I put a lot of enthusiasm into it.
Two tongues. Is that the Caesar?
Okay, great. Thank you.
Very good.
Have you just washed that salad?
Yes.
You just washed it then?
Yep.
Because it's soaking wet. So all the dressings just run off it because the lettuce is soaking wet. To dress a Caesar salad, the salad has to be crisp but dry. So you've made all that freaking work for nothing.
Oh my God, 8 minutes for nothing.
Kim, you think he's gonna like the food?
I think so. Frank is so defeated right now that he's lost the confidence in himself as a chef and in his abilities.
The eggplant is in the window. Want to get Andrew?
The addiction, what was it?
Painkillers.
Painkillers?
Yeah. I'll say it's heroin.
Heroin.
Really never been in trouble with the law before that.
No.
No. First time, happened to be the Fed.
Now, how long did you spend inside?
Almost 4 years.
You've been clean for how long now?
Almost 2 years.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
2 years clean. Brilliant.
Yeah, it's nice.
Here we have the eggplant, the involtini di melanzane.
Thank you. Strange. Mm-hmm. Strange, soggy. Hasn't been fried or cooked long enough.
Not.
Yeah, it's pretty spongy and horrible. Are they frozen?
No, that's fresh.
When were they done?
This morning.
Really? Will you just check if that was done this morning? Because it tastes like it was done last week.
I'll tell Frank.
Thank you.
Frank, what? You said this was spongy?
What was?
When were they made? He asked me if they were frozen. I said, no, they're not.
3 weeks ago. Yeah, there's a batch of freezer. They don't make them too hot every day.
I'll go tell them.
I can't make eggplant too hot. That's impossible. I don't have time.
You gotta say what they meant.
Unless he has a new method I don't know about.
His method's gonna be, he's gonna get here at 11 in the morning. That's what the method is, Frank.
Well, it's impossible to be here at 11 in the morning.
No, it's not, Frank. Frank is a very lazy cook. He doesn't even fry the eggplants anymore. My mother and father end up frying it. Ridiculous.
Eggplant made yesterday?
It was actually made 3 weeks ago. Yep.
3 weeks ago?
Yep. That's disgusting. Do you go grocery shopping 3 weeks in advance before you're gonna eat the stuff? No.
All right, give me a pen, I need to keep score. It's one down, one eggplant, not good. Lobster ravioli, that should be fine.
What's next?
Lobster ravioli.
And were these made yesterday?
Yeah, I'll make sure I get a date on that.
What is that? It's like a goo.
Some of the lobster ravioli made.
I do not know. The manufacturer does that. They are not homemade.
I definitely feel dumb. You know, Here I am telling people, you know, all the pastas are handmade, because that's what Frank told me. I feel betrayed in my own boss. It's not right.
That's nasty.
The lobster ravioli is store-bought.
So it's not fresh?
No.
Hold on a minute, hold on. We're backtracking now. Fresh pasta every day.
All the pastas, handmade.
Yeah, all handmade.
I thought they were made fresh.
Why would you have to store-bought? That's gross.
You can never say to Frank, Frank, why aren't the pastas handmade? Why don't you come in earlier and make pastas? So I hope that you can get through to him, because he is a good chef.
But is he a passionate chef?
No.
No.
Wow. Jeez. Okay. Thank you, Andrew.
All right.
Did you say you liked it or you didn't like it?
He hated the lobster ravioli.
You didn't like nothing. I really want to please the guy. I know he's going to complain. I mean, come on. At least, like, tell me if the sauce was good. I mean, that's all I ask. If she doesn't like this, then, like, what the f***? I'm busting again. She's got to like something.
A lamb.
Uh-huh.
Just served in a garlic and rosemary crust. Mm-hmm. And a Barolo red wine sauce. Buon appetito.
Thank you. What kind of crust is that?
Rosemary
garlic.
Garlic
and rosemary.
Mm-hmm. It's burnt. It's burnt and bitter. When garlic burns, it goes bitter. I can't even taste lamb.
I felt embarrassed by some of the dishes that came out.
Wow.
And again, passion gone.
Anthony, take me to the kitchen, please. You're going to have a word with Frank.
I definitely think we're screwed.
Okay, let's start. I sat down. I got told the pasta's fresh. I got excited. It's homemade and it's coming from the heart. All of a sudden, you got this ravioli lobster. That's store-bought. It was horrible.
But how was the sauce?
Who gives about the sauce? The filling is the magic. Whether it's a ravioli or tortellini, it's the filling you get excited about. The eggplant. But that was a disaster. Spongy, bitter, undercooked. And then I got told it was cooked 3 weeks ago. Embarrassing. I mean, it's really embarrassing. You can't make fresh food and freeze it and charge money to run a business. If you can't even be bothered to cook fresh food, what do you want me to do? Wave a magic wand and turn this place around? Come on!
This is what I do. I don't know how to do any better.
That's a lie. You could do much better.
Well, do you want to do better? That's the big question. I'm gonna get some fresh air. I'll be back later, yeah? Unbelievable.
13 years I've been here, Chef Ramsay tasting the menu was like the worst experience I've ever had.
Hell.
At least tell me, the sauce was half decent.
Yeah, but you can't be begging for a compliment, Frank.
I'm not begging for a compliment.
But
you were
at the end.
You always played something.
Frankie thinks he knows everything. He's not going to hear it from anyone. You'll need help. He may say Ramsay, too. I don't know.
It comes down to us being here or not being here, Frank. You know it. I know it. It's not news.
We have someone here willing to help you. Do you want to learn from him? Dead seriously. Dead seriously.
I don't know.
Well, you have to make a decision today.
Upset after Chef Ramsay's harsh critique of his dishes.
Do you want to do this?
I don't know.
Frank is not only questioning the future of Davide, but his own.
Mentally, when I'm out at the restaurant, is total frustration because there's so many bad old memories.
Where's Frank? Oh, they're there. We go down there, a little booth.
I'm thinking.
Come on. You can sit down on your ass to think.
My seat of depression.
Your boss represents the company. If you see your boss slacking off, what's that tell you? I mean, he doesn't even dress up in a chef's jacket. Who am I busting my ass for?
With seemingly the weight of the world on his shoulders, Frank is about to face a busy night, as word has leaked out that Chef Ramsay is at Davide.
Welcome to Davide.
Not the lobster.
Okay.
Now have the veal chop.
Okay, order then.
But back in the kitchen.
Frank, come on.
It appears as though Frank has given up before dinner has even started.
Frank, come on.
The only reason why I don't quit is because I'm too proud.
Let's go.
One salmon, one tag, one shrimp, no fritters.
Enjoy your dinner.
As orders continue to pile into the kitchen.
I'm waiting on a duck and a salmon.
I got the duck right here.
Can I call a table 20, please?
Table 20.
A depressed Frank tries to get motivated.
What's up on table 10, Zap? 3 eggplant, 3 fag.
Yeah, I'm f***ing it up right now.
But it's not long before the kitchen is backed up.
Excuse me. Do you know where?
They are coming out. They are coming out. The kitchen's a little bit behind.
I need 2 fettuccine bolognese on the fly.
Hey, Anthony, slow it the down.
What do you think I'm doing?
Shut up. I know what you want.
My brother, I hate his attitude. I hate working with him because, like, I can't tell Frank anything without him telling me to go myself.
Table 31, been waiting an hour.
Please shut the up.
Talk to each other. You guys say nothing. It's just like the blind leading the blind.
Well, I think Ramsay is great because it's like he's the only one he's going to listen to.
Table 10.
It's out there.
If we listen to him.
I'm waiting on 32.
Can't cook that fast.
I need every next course in my room.
Rush, rush, rush. What the f*** is it with this society?
I need 2 bolognese right up behind.
Eddie.
Yeah?
They're going to send this back. All right, start cooking another one because they're going to send it back.
This goes to table 5. Do it now.
Fish was bad. I was like, let it roll. They took a gamble. I mean, it doesn't look pretty, but if they like it, they like it. If not...
I'm sorry, this was really dry. Thank you very much.
And there's salmon on the fly, table 5. Too dry.
What's wrong?
What did I tell you?
Frank, you knew that was coming back. Why did you send it?
Because they're going to get a complaint either way. They're going to wait too long, but they're going to send it back.
I'd rather they wait and have it perfect than wait and send to come back. Sad as that. When a chef doesn't care, that means the restaurant goes downhill rapidly. And that's exactly what's happening tonight. I think Frank is way too burnt out. Right now, it's more depressing than anything. Unbelievable.
It's an hour and a half into dinner service.
Table 20 and table 3, that's what I'm putting up.
And food is slowly making its way out to the diners.
No, that's gross.
But unfortunately, it's not worth the wait.
Frank, this is lukewarm.
Yes, son of a bitch. You and your lemon juice, stupid chicken out of trouble.
Pardon me.
Oh, no, what?
He says it's overdone.
Shut the f*** up. This is the way it is. Don't come back with it.
This is it. This is a breaking point of this restaurant right here.
Food sucks anyway, and I'm putting up.
Frank needs to make a commitment to working hard. And if you don't have that passion, you don't have it, and you got to get out of here.
Any more slips coming in?
Frank, we're screwed.
I'm not cooking. I'm not doing it. I'm done.
So what, you don't like it?
This is lukewarm.
Too dry.
He says it's overdone.
It may only be halfway into dinner service.
It's horrible.
Frank, we're screwed.
I'm not cooking. I'm not doing it.
But owner Frank has had enough.
Might not go back in tonight.
I definitely lost the passion for cooking or for being in the restaurant business, period. I don't know what to do anymore.
With Frank abandoning the kitchen, sous chef Eddie and the rest of the staff finish off a painful dinner service.
Chicken bongo style?
Sorry about that.
Folks, thank you very much. Have a good night.
Tonight I saw something quite frightening. Wasn't the bad food, wasn't the complaints, and it certainly wasn't the service. It was Frank. And here's why. Watching him, he is so burnt out. He's given up. It's like a ticking time bomb that's about to explode.
I know. I love him, and I've seen how much over the years he's done for everyone. And all, and he feels so defeated.
I can see it.
And he just
come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey, I don't want to see you like this. Hey.
That's why we called you, because we want to help.
This is not about a guy that can't be bothered to cook. He is done. He's on the floor.
I know.
And he's barely breathing.
What do we do?
We start by bringing him back. Tonight, take 10 minutes out and think of something you've never said to him before that can help to inspire him. Do you understand?
Yes.
Good night.
Good night. Thank you very much.
Frank is stubborn, but he's got a good heart.
I think he thinks I'm against him. It's really not like that.
You know, it's my brother.
I love him.
But if we can't work together, without a doubt, we will close the doors.
Frank has clearly lost his passion.
Mommy.
And unfortunately, his family and his business are being dragged down with him.
Let's sit down.
Chef Ramsay knows that if this restaurant has any chance of surviving, he must find a way to inspire Frank.
Take a seat. When I watched you last night, from start to finish, it upset me. And here's why. I witnessed a broken man. I could see all the stress has killed your spirit. I spoke to Kim and Anthony late last night, and they both just want to say something to you personally. Anthony.
I wrote it down. Good speech.
Frank, we both know we're not good at this stuff, so. All right. Frank, I think you have been so overwhelmed for so long, and for good reason. I know how much damage I've done.
You can. It's all
right. Big deep breath. Come on.
It's all right.
Yeah. And you had to hold it together. Now I believe you need to take care of yourself. You and I both know that you have it in you to get back into life. No matter what we say to each other, you know if it comes down to it, I'm always there. I think we lost sight of what we really count. I believe we can really make this place work. You know that we can, if we put the effort into it. We don't ever say it, but I do love you. That's it.
My brother's never, that's the first time I heard any remorse from him. Legitimate remorse. Should I listen or should I not listen? Oh.
Kim?
To say I love you is an understatement. And to say that I'm always beside you, I think you know that. The past 12 years have been the hardest of our lives, but we made it through together because we love each other. And I look at the way you talk to people lately and the mean things that come out of your mouth. And I think it comes from you holding this burden for the whole family for so long on your shoulders. You haven't put this chef jacket on in 4 years. Because I think inside you felt you didn't deserve it anymore. But you do. You're actually one of the most talented people I've ever met in my life. That lack of passion that showed in the food yesterday for Gordon was a cry for help. You are worth it, and you deserve success, and you've worked hard for it, and you deserve it, Frank. But the only way this place is gonna make it is you have to look within you and break down this wall that you've built. Please put this back on. No, I'm serious.
I don't deserve to wear that jacket because a schmuck could put out the food I was putting out. You don't wear a uniform if you don't produce.
Put it back on.
Not yet.
After an emotional,
we don't ever say it, but I do love you,
and hopeful plea from his family.
Please put this back on.
Not yet.
Chef Ramsay goes to work.
I don't care about the that's been kicked into you years ago. You got to cook.
Trying to reignite Frank's passion in the kitchen.
I want you to think of something that you want to cook and put the passion on the plate, not the anger.
Ramsay didn't like a friggin' thing that I made yesterday. I don't know what to do to please the guy.
What are you thinking of doing?
Oh my God, it's total blank.
I hope he thinks it's good.
Fancy this in a simple lemon capeaway wine?
Nice.
I
like to see your mind working, you know that. It means your passion's coming back.
Frankie has the talent to put out that kind of food. If he gets dedicated, it could be done. If not, it's over.
What have you got in the sauce?
Shallots, thyme, a little dash of rosemary. No good?
It's delicious. You're always on the defensive. Who said no good?
You ripped me a little out there.
And if I got served that yesterday as my entree, I'd be like a pig in.
He liked it.
Cooking with Chef Ramsay made me feel like I was cooking at the old days, the way I had passion about doing things.
Absolutely delicious. Good.
Now that Frank's spirit has been lifted, Chef Ramsay decides to go ahead with phase two of his plan, giving a facelift to the tired decor of Davide.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Frank, how are you?
Too nervous.
Great. Let's go. Come in, come in, come in.
Oh, my God.
Look at this.
Nice.
Oh, beautiful.
God, Frank, oh, it's beautiful.
Welcome to the new Davide. Right, where should we start? A new modern appeal. Gone are the old dreadful chairs.
Nice.
We've replaced them with stunning new mahogany chairs. Beautiful. Okay, take a look at this.
That is awesome.
By replacing those dreadful white walls above the stone, we've contemporized the dining room. Now we've got textured material. It's lit underneath. It is going to look absolutely beautiful. And what about the Davide sconces? Aren't they beautiful?
They are absolutely gorgeous.
Have a look at these booths. You know we swapped the banquets for the booths. This is now a fresh, modern vibe.
Absolutely beautiful.
Bella, 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 bella.
Everything is perfect, Gordon. We couldn't have asked for anything more.
These were things that we were never able to do because we were so far down in death.
So
and to see a Frank cry, it's overwhelming.
It's everything we wanted to do.
I've been down here in this grave for 27 years. Now it's like totally everything is different and modernized. I can feel it, that the hope is coming back.
Frankie, can I just say something?
You can please put that away.
Frankie, please, you need to wear a chef's coat, because you're a chef. Take this off and please, please, for me. You're a chef. You're really here.
It's the first time I wore a jacket, it's 4 years. I didn't want people to know I was the head chef back here.
It's a symbol of that you are back. You can do this because you're better than any shot I've ever taken. Am I the right way?
They're looking nice.
See him put on the coat to me meant that, yes, I'm taking this all seriously, and it just means a lot to me.
And now you look like it's the chef that you are because you can do it.
A touching sentiment for my wife. But jacket doesn't make the person. Gives you a way to go there, but it doesn't make the person.
Now that Frank appears ready to command the kitchen, it's time for the final phase of Chef Ramsay's plan, the menu.
Have a look at this.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
The future of Davide is right in front of your eyes, on the table.
It looks so nice.
Gone are the dreadful plates of the 80s. The appetizers. Bruschetta, roasted peppers with a cape of berries, marinated baby tomatoes, burrata. How could we be a modern Italian restaurant without any burrata? Then the pièce de résistance, the main course, homemade gnocchi, brown butter, truffle oil, and some fresh chives at the end. Homemade. Stress that every time. Homemade, yeah? Pork tenderloin. Frank, your chicken, lemon chicken. We've put an onion compote on there as well.
Wow.
Tonight, we relaunch the modern Davide. Dig in.
There's no one in the Northern that does this new menu.
Awesome. I am overwhelmed.
It's a kick-ass menu.
Tastes
oh my
that's
God.
That's delicious.
Gordon put his touch, changed the whole menu into what it needs to be for this type of a city with this many restaurants, and that's what's going to set us apart from all the others.
The chicken, I like it, though.
That looks good.
Munch, munch, taste everything, munch.
It's only an hour before dinner service.
Take a seat there, bud.
And Chef Ramsay has one more important message for Frank.
Anthony's never going to be perfect in your eyes. But for a recovering addict to be clean for 2 years...
It's good.
Yeah. It's not bad. I wish my brother was clean. I wish he had kicked his habit. They were a similar age.
And the crap that we go through on a daily basis is just extraordinary. But cut him some slack and get him by your side. Help him. Because I think when you start helping him, he's going to come back 10 times over.
He will.
Yeah.
No.
Maybe I've been too tough with Anthony. Me and Anthony can have to work together to turn the restaurant around.
Yeah, of course it's going to be hard. It's never going to be easy.
No, nothing ever is if you want it.
You can do it. I know you can do it.
I won't let you down. You got my passion back.
It's so amazing that this is coming up.
It's relaunch night at Davide.
Okay, it's showtime, guys.
And Frank is already feeling the pressure.
Holy Mary, Mother of God. I never felt this nervous before. I don't want to disappoint anybody, and I want to prove it to myself I can do it.
But Chef Ramsay has some important information that is going to make the evening even more intense.
I've just had a call, listen to me, yeah? Tonight, you've got the Boston Magazine coming in as well.
Tonight, the stakes were raised from the beginning.
So, eyes wide open, yeah?
And now it's going to be Boston Magazine's in the restaurant. And that's a big deal. I'm ready to go.
Buonasera. You're welcome to Davide. Tonight, we change the menu.
We're going to order a bunch of different appetizers.
Right this way, please.
Thank you.
Black shrimp pizza.
I'll do the Tuscan bread soup.
With the restaurant packed.
Boston Magazine have just arrived.
Table day on.
15.
Let's do it.
The first tickets are in. Frank is about to face his first big test.
All right, five's coming up.
All the tables have high priority.
Appetizers up, that's the soup, pizza right here.
But the Boston Magazine, it affects the business. They write a bad review.
Oh, that's pretty.
Enjoy.
This is really good. I would love the recipe. I would love to make this at home.
While the critics from the Boston Magazine are clearly pleased with their appetizers, they aren't the only ones.
Delicious.
And for the first time in a long time,
yeah, it's excellent.
This quaint dining room in the north end of Boston is buzzing.
Frank, a new order just came in.
But back in the kitchen.
Expediter, I need entrees on table 12 immediately.
Okay.
Frank, talk to each other a little bit, yeah?
Yeah.
The mood is starting to turn, and the tension is building between the brothers.
Cappellini Pappardelle is the second course, and I got a gnocchi and a fusilli right now.
As Anthony pushes Frank to finish the Boston Magazine's entrees.
Keep it together, come on. Coordinator, yes?
Table 15, Frank, next course. 2 ravioli, 1 pork.
Yes, yes, we start at 15.
It's very rare the Boston Magazine come out like that, a drop of a hat, and that pork is working.
Frank, please, can I get the pork so I can complete? Come on, Frank, we haven't got the other two. Give me.
That's it. Don't ever rush me.
Come on, give me.
I'll put it up on the tray.
Give me. Go. Thank you.
That looks beautiful.
Yeah. I like
that. Wow.
The pork is a little... Should we send it back?
Pork not good?
Yeah, it's still a little bit.
You want it more pork?
Yeah, just like pink but not red, you know?
I wanted to make a good impression. Oh, my God. It was a disaster. Table 15, one of the football.
It's the Boston Magazine.
My God, what's the
Frank, you're going to be the biggest in Boston in 5 minutes now, yeah? Come on!
The one after came back, that table had to come back.
This is a disaster.
Oh.
It's Davide's grand reopening.
The pork is a little raw.
And a critical mistake at the Boston Magazine table.
Too raw, Frank, the pork.
It's the Boston Magazine.
Has Frank's confidence completely shaken.
My God, what's the...
You got another one going? What's up?
What's up? What
do you want to communicate?
I let Chef Ramsay down, I let myself down, I let everybody down.
The one off it came back, that table had to come back.
That was not the table to screw up.
Listen. We can pull this back. We can pull it back. Come on. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
I know it's undercooked, but we can get it going, yeah?
I'm pissed
at myself.
Come on,
you know, but you can't let it follow.
No, can't let
it destroy.
I almost went back to the old ways, but I took a deep breath and I was like, okay, I gotta refocus here.
I'm not giving up. I'm tired, but I'm not giving up.
Pork tandem.
I got
15.
The pork.
Okay. Here you go.
Here's the pork. That can
refight. That's 15. Take it out.
Come back strong, yeah? Let's go.
Thank God I was trying to impress you tonight.
I'm sorry.
Make sure it's good.
It's good.
excited to see what happens, you know, the next few months here.
Anthony, buy me some dips. Come on.
Table 21, table 23, pick up.
If you two continue talking, we're going to get there.
Yes, sir.
Good.
The relationship with Anthony is still fractured. That's what's holding us back in the restaurant. But he's been trying harder. I see it. So I'm willing to compromise.
With Anthony supporting Frank in the kitchen.
Anthony, table 10.
Nice.
Come on, guys, bring it together over there.
Beautiful.
Welcome, Manning.
I come back for that.
The two brothers complete dinner service on a high.
That's the amount of restaurant can be every night.
Wow, what a night.
Yeah, good and bad.
Trust me, mostly good. Think back to my first day here. I saw a family in turmoil, and a chef that was sitting down in the kitchen, depressed. But tonight, I saw a family come together and pull off a strong service. Frank, you proved to me tonight that you can run a kitchen. The way you handled the pressure was phenomenal.
Yes. I feel grateful beyond words. For Frankie to hear Gordon say that you can do this 100%, it just means so much because he deserves this. I can't say thank you enough.
And Frank, keep that chef jacket on, keep that attitude with it, and never sit down in a kitchen ever again. I'm rooting for your success.
I'm real excited for the future. My goal now is to keep the passion going. This is a new day for Davide. And for me.
Good night, guys. Good luck. Yes?
Yes.
Good luck, good luck, good luck. And more importantly,
just stay calm.
That's it, just stay calm. Passionate man in there with a lot to give. Okay?
Don't stop.
This is why. I'll crack a smile from time to time, yeah?
I will.
Take care, bud.
There's no words that you could describe what I'm feeling right now. It's overwhelming. Totally overwhelming.
Good night, Chef.
Good night. Thank you.
For the last 10 years, Boston has seemed to ignore Davide. But now, with this huge turnaround with the food and the staff, it's got every right to return to its former glory. My God. People think I've got a funny accent.
In the weeks that followed, Frank's rediscovered passion for cooking flourished.
I'll take care of it, one at a time.
He's back in love with food.
Hot. I want to make myself proud, my family proud, and Chef Ramsay proud.
And the city of Boston is reaping the benefits.
What do you think?
Very good.
As for his brother Anthony.
Yes, thank you, beautiful.
He too has made a comeback.
Very nice to see you, Ned.
He is clearly committed to the restaurant.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And more importantly, to his brother. Next time on Kitchen Nightmares, Chef Ramsay finds an owner in complete denial.
That was embarrassing.
You're full of
this hot-headed woman battles him.
I'm not gonna listen to you.
Every step of the way. Can Chef Ramsay get through to this stubborn owner?
You stuck-up, precious little bitch.
Or is she so delusional?
Blame me all you want. You're insane.
I'm insane. You're insane.
That she chases her one last hope out the door.
Get out of my restaurant, please.
Not now, guys, please.
Get ready for the most shocking kitchen nightmares of the season.